Earlier, I spoke with Public Safety Minister Bill Blair. Again, as of next Monday, air travelers landing in Canada will have to quarantine in a government-mandated hotel for 3 days at their own expense. People still also have to provide proof of a negative COVID test and quarantine for 14 days and submit their quarantine plan online. There are some exemptions for essential workers, like healthcare workers, for instance, but there are other people who still have questions and would like to see exemptions, particularly for certain medical travelers, like my next guest. Kim Muise has stage 4 cervical cancer, and she's been traveling from her home in Vancouver to Los Angeles once a month for the past year so she can receive cancer treatment in an American clinical trial. Kim, nice to see you. We've been emailing through the week, so nice to see your face finally.
Yeah, it's nice to speak with you, Rosemary. Good morning.
Yeah, good morning to you. So maybe let's just start by you explaining to everyone sort of why you have to do this every month and how important it is mm-hmm. to you.
Okay, for sure. Thank you. So as you said, I have stage 4 cervical cancer, and earlier in the year in 2020, my cancer had a recurrence. And on the recommendation of my Canadian oncologist, we started looking at clinical trials in the United States and found the one I'm on currently in Los Angeles. And it's working really well. At the moment, my scans show that I'm cancer-free or not showing any active cancer. And I feel healthy. I feel so much better than prior to my treatment. And it's literally saving my life. And it's critical that I am able to continue accessing my treatment.
Yeah, well, that's great news that it's working. How challenging has it been, though? Because even without now this hotel component, you do have to go home and quarantine for 2 weeks every time you come back, right?
Yeah, it's incredibly challenging for our family. I have 2 young kids. They're 7 and 10. And when I quarantine, they quarantine with me. And that means that throughout the summer, in the fall, they were unable to go outside even so much to go for a bike ride or a walk. It's hard as well for, you know, my mental health, our mental health for our whole family. And particularly while I battle cancer, you know, it's really important for me to get exercise and fresh air and sunshine. And it's I'm unable to do that essentially half of my life.
What are your concerns around this added layer now that's going to start next Monday of the quarantining in hotels?
Yeah, honestly, when I heard the news about that, I was distraught. The idea of having to be separated from my children for longer than needed, 3 days, and quarantine at a hotel at a cost of $2,000 for the privilege. It was very upsetting, and I didn't know what to do, so I felt the only thing I could do was share my story.
Yeah, and I think you've been heard. I did put this to Minister of Public Safety Bill Blair. I'm gonna play you a clip because he seemed quite aware of your situation. Here he is.
In a consultation with the Public Health Agency of Canada and with the BC Health Authority to make sure that situation, and it is a compelling situation,
yes.
and you know, we want to make sure that woman can receive her treatment and put in measures that can protect her, protect her family, and protect her community, but also deal with, you know, the exceptional circumstances that woman is experiencing in an appropriate way.
So what do you make of that, Kim? Does that provide you any reassurance?
Somewhat, yes. We've been appealing to so many agencies for months and essentially got nothing back but letters that say, while we sympathize, copy paste, you are not exempt, type form letters. So it is comforting to know that my message has finally been received, but it took quite a lot of work to get there.
Yeah. Do you understand the need, though, for you to quarantine in your own home? I realize that presents challenges for your family, but do you understand from a public health perspective why that is also important?
I do understand the desire, the want for me to quarantine in my home. The reality is I'm very low risk. My travel is very safe. I take every precaution. If I was to contract COVID, it would be absolutely catastrophic because I would be unable to continue my travel and receive treatment, and therefore I would, the cancer could come back and it could kill me.
Yeah.
So my life is literally on the line to not contract COVID or even so much as the flu or a cold, because any COVID-like symptoms would prevent me from being able to travel. So I'm very low risk when it comes to as an individual, and I have to draw comparisons to the fact that there are exemptions for people coming into Canada to seek medical treatment. They have a blanket exemption. Yet Canadians who have to go abroad to seek medical treatment that is unavailable in Canada don't have the same equivalent exemption.
Okay. Kim, I'm going to leave it there. I'm glad you got in touch with me, and thanks for sharing your story. I know that wasn't easy, but it's important because I know there's other people in your situation too.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Rosemary.
Yeah, take care of yourself, Kim. Nice to meet you finally.
Yeah, you too.